The country's franchising industry expected to see a 10 to 13% growth in the next 5 years, with food and service sectors still driving those numbers. Let's talk more about franchising and the upcoming expo featuring the next best things in business. Sam Christopher Lim, president of the Philippine Franchise Association, is on the Business Roadshow today for this chat. Hi, Sam.
Hi, thanks for having us here.
It's good to have you here. Now, you're holding once again the biggest and longest running franchise show in Asia. We're eager to know more about that. But first, let's talk about the size and breadth of this event. How many local and international brands do you have in store?
Well, you know, we're proud. Not only are we the biggest in Asia, this year we're the biggest in the world, actually. Cool. So we have about 1,000 brands joining us. And about 20% of these are international brands. We have people from brands from about 20 plus countries coming here, ranging from Australia, Japan, Korea, Thailand, the US, Europe. We have delegates coming as far away as Mexico, Uruguay, Latin America.
Wow.
So it's really a big global event happening here this year.
Wow. And can you give us an idea of those brands that you're featuring? At least some.
Yeah, I mean, on the local level, of course, you have the Maxis Group, the Shawarma Shack, the Generics Pharmacy. But internationally as well, we have things like Subway, Mailboxes, etc., and quite a few others from all over the world.
All right, Sam, the event also showcases just what business opportunities that one may explore post-pandemic. Perhaps can you give us a sense of these types of businesses? What are the go-to franchises perhaps in the future? Because mainly there's food, there's service, and there's the agriculture sector, which is also a potential. So what do you have in store for those looking for a business?
It's very exciting because 40% of the brands coming are new. So, you know, we have such unique brands such as, you talked about it, agriculture, you know, from agri-vets, agri-retailers to agricultural drone franchises. We have a lot of those coming in. But also we have in the food sector, of course, whether it's a new milk tea brands and latest shawarma brands, latest food and services. Equally important, we have a lot of international brands. We have brands such as K-Skin, which is from Singapore. It's a 15-minute skin rejuvenation franchise. We also have mga fashion and as well as mga health franchises like gyms that are coming in.
And have you noticed an increase in the franchisable, if you will, businesses in the past few years, especially after the pandemic? Are people now more engaged in terms of finding a brand or a business that they can franchise and promote?
Definitely. I think from the brand owners, we see a lot of them realizing they have to diversify. So a lot of them are actually getting into franchising, so they diversify their business. But from the people buying a franchise, we've seen a lot more. People have realized now, you know, just having one's income, let's say your job, may not be as stable as you think it was. So a lot are trying to diversify, getting you know, a side business that they can run part-time, trying to earn that income on top of the normal income they get from their jobs.
Okay.
And we've also seen a lot of landlords get into franchising. Kaya we see that 10 to 13% growth in the industry.
Okay, Sam, based on what you're seeing, what are you liking? What new businesses are well, sparking your curiosity and interest?
For me, it's two really. It's medical and agricultural. So medical, you know, the dialysis centers, diagnostic centers. Government does continue investing a lot in the healthcare of our kababayans. So, you know, dialysis centers, diagnostic centers doing very well, especially because it's supported as well by government.
Okay.
On the agriculture side, you know, we know the focus on agriculture of this administration. Kaya we've been seeing a lot more agricultural franchises, those servicing really the farms, the agriculture sector, para ma-stabilize siya. And you know, we get the best practices. It's converting mom and pop, whether it's in the retail sector or the service side. Something focused on agriculture, we're looking at that as a sunrise industry.
And what about sunset industries? Are there specific sectors that are not as hot anymore?
You know, there's always, it's hard to tell right now, you know. I think it's something we have to look at during the show.
Okay.
To see really what more are the sunset industries. But we do continue to see a lot of the industries continue to grow.
All right. Now, part of your campaign is education as well as promotion. What sessions can participants expect now from the gathering in terms of learning and in terms of even learning how to invest? for starters.
Yeah. You know, normally we have about two types of seminars for these sessions. But this year we have about seven different ones. You know, those looking for a franchise, we have the How to Invest in a Franchise. We have a masterclass, you know, being conducted by a Singaporean professional about a masterclass on acquiring a franchise. Even someone from Malaysia talking about how to acquire an international franchise. So and daming different ways of acquiring a franchise.
Right.
We have that. For business owners, we have things like how to franchise your business, 5 ways to grow your profit, a session with some of the franchising icons internationally, and knowing yourself to grow your brand, you know. So a lot of these very diverse sessions para not only can you find a franchise, you can find ways to grow your business.
Okay, a loftier goal perhaps, aside from promoting the entrepreneurial spirit, is growth, as you want to see the brands succeed, not just locally, but overseas as well. Talk to us now about internationalization. Now, are you seeing more Filipino brands and businesses breaking the international barrier?
Definitely. One of our goals in the PFA is we want 50 new market entries for our Filipino brands. Kasi, you know, we're the seventh largest franchise market in the world. Uh-huh. But internationally, we're underrepresented.
Okay.
So we've been working a lot. And it's not just Manila brands. It's, you know, it's Cebu, Davao, Iloilo, brands from all over the country. We're trying to get a lot of them to go international. And one way we do this is definitely education as well. We've been mentoring I think at least 50 new brands over the past year. We've been trying to mentor to get them ready. We're even releasing a book, you know, Unlocking the Franchise Secrets of Internationalizing Your Brands. It's his first ever book of these 10 brands, 10 of our global Filipino brands. We interviewed them, and they're sharing a lot of their secrets, and we're launching that in October during Franchise Asia. So we really want to educate and prepare our kababayans to be able to go international.
You know, a lot of investors would say capitalization is really a major stumbling block in terms of expansion and going global. But really, what are the weaknesses, the other weaknesses aside from capital, of Philippine products? Why aren't some of them not making it?
You know, the weakness is also the strength, because our market is so big. You know, we're the seventh largest market in the world. You have brands that reach 500, 1,000 branches here in the Philippines. I think the problem sometimes is we're so comfortable and we can make good income here in the Philippines. We forget that, you know, there's 100 million people here in the Philippines, but 600 million all over ASEAN and, you know, the other billions all over the world. So I think it's just looking at how to expand their horizons, looking beyond the Philippines, and really just even just entering ASEAN, that's automatically 600 million target consumers.
Okay, Sam, on the flip side of promoting Philippine businesses is encouraging foreign brands also to set up base here in the country. Now, what do you think makes the Philippines a favorable investment destination?
You know, the Philippines is the franchise hub of Asia. They love our market because there's so many, there's, you know, 100 million population, but we're very young, you know, an average age of 24 years old. So a lot of them actually want to enter here. But equally important, they see the skill level of the Filipinos. You know, a lot of these international brands, they actually make the Philippines their training hub of ASEAN. So it's their stepping stone into Southeast Asia. Kaya this year, you know, we have pavilions coming from the US, from Korea. A lot of these international, supported by their governments, they're trying to set up base here in the Philippines.
Okay, Sam, tell us now about the franchise show. When and where is this happening, and how can one be a part of it?
Well, I want to invite you all to the largest franchise show in the world, October 27 to 29. It's going to be the SMX Mall of Asia. It's free registration. You just go to franchiseasiaph.com, you register. As long as you register online, you can enter for free. It's a three-day event. It's going to be the big global event with over 40 countries coming in. So we'd love to have you here.
All right, Mr. Sam Christopher Lim, President of Philippine Franchise Association. We are looking forward to another successful Franchise Expo. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you very much.